Hi everybody, I hope you are doing well. Here, I want to introduce a new batch of videos. Videos where I will talk in English, because English is English and I want to share this message to all French learners, okay? From the beginners to the higher level, okay? So I think in English it will be more easy to be well understood, okay? And also dedicate to this message to the other people who may be interested in the message I will share with you. In these videos in general, I want to share what I consider as solutions to be more efficient. I mean, reach more easier your objectives, okay? Get closer to your patients and be more happy in general. Today, I want to start with honesty. One pillar, in my opinion, to be more happy. When I say honesty, I mean a very, very deep honesty in you, deep honesty with yourself, which means acting and doing what really pleases to you, doing what you enjoy, knowing well your patients and enter in the circle where you enjoy, and then you are more motivated and then more efficient, and you see this circle which creates your performance. But how to do? I think the first step is to know in what you are really interested in. There are probably many activities you are interested in, but the intensity most of the time is different between the activities. And you know, it's important to know what is the intensity you feel for the different activities. Probably learning French hasn't the same intensity for you than gardening outdoor. It's probably different. And the main idea in it is to avoid, you know, to fix a big objective, okay, but for an activity for which you don't have a big intensity of joy, okay? An activity you do not desire a lot, okay? So how to do to know well what is the intensity you feel for an activity? I think the main trick is to ask yourself, okay, some questions. For example, if we take the example of learning French, you can ask yourself first, what do you want, okay, about French? What do you expect from French language? A second question, very important, very interesting, is how this activity, how learning French is important for you. And for each question, you have to bring, okay, some answers, but also try to, okay, study the feelings you have inside you, okay? When you ask these questions, how it's important for you, in which measure it's important for you, you have also to study your feelings to see, okay, if you get some kind of message from your guts, okay, from your belly, to see, to try to get the good answers, okay? Because something very interesting is to get the emotional answers, okay? So you can ask in which measure it's important for you. You can also ask in which measure do you desire this activity? In which measure do you desire improving it, okay? And which priority are you able to give it in your life? Which portion of your life are you able to dedicate to this activity? What is the priority of this activity in your life, and which portion of this of your life are you able to dedicate to this activity? Second type of questions, very interesting, you can ask yourself is, in what is the priority of this activity in your life, and try to compare it with the other activities. And then it's interesting to know which portion of your life you want to dedicate to this activity. And by this way, you know, you will fix the real priority, because sometimes you want to dedicate big amount of time to this activity, but then you know that in terms of priority, it's not on the top level. So you can then manage the different levels you have and put some kind of pyramid of the activities. Usually it does not require a lot of time to ask you this question. But what you should know is that for sure it will bring some answers, some solutions, very, very helpful to fix and reach your objectives and reach it efficiently. Once you know what really pleases to you, the second step is to act. And to act starts by being really yourself, assume it, dedicate time to these activities you love in order to preserve it. And also you assume it with yourself, okay, but with the others. And what a powerful, beautiful levers to be more happy, to change your life also. You know, being yourself means that sometimes you won't do the unanimity, okay? It's not necessary that everybody will agree with you. For example, if you learn French, for some people, and potentially some of your friends, you may be in disagreement, or they may be in disagreement with you. They may consider that it's not useful, and they may have opinions for you, but opinions you don't share, okay? This doesn't mean that it won't be your friend anymore, but by assuming your friend, you will know, you know, more about yourself, and also about the relations you have with them. I mean, this is a good way to, you know, to make a selecting in these relations. For example, if this person, this friend, does not agree with you, then you will not debate about it anymore, or maybe you will try to debate, but finally you will avoid to spend that much energy to convince this person. And being honest will also, just in general, influence your relations. You know, if you are honest, if you don't act, if you really talk, for example, about what you deeply love, okay? You love French, you talk about French with the people you meet. This is one of the topics you start to speak about when you meet somebody. You speak about your passion, then very fastly, very efficiently, you will know how it talks to this person, if the person is interesting, okay, or not. And for sure, it will help to you to do this selecting with the person with who you can have a conversation, you can have exchanges which are constructive, okay, or a person which does not react, okay, or worst, a person which is toxic for you. And then you can perform this selecting and choose to go with the persons to which are nourishing you. Go to the person you want to spend time with, and I let you think about this potential. But in my opinion, this is the way to create the relations you need. You need to help you in your objectives, help you to be more, I don't know, in French, you know, we say épanoui, be more open, okay, be more productive potentially, get more joy, in general, just be more happy. I conclude with this idea of the potential of the relation with the others, how it may help you to be more efficient, to have more joy in your life, get closer to the happiness, spend more time to your patients. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you think it may help someone else, just share it with this person. I wish you the best, and say you goodbye.